Welcome to brand new show Face to Face. This is an initiative of DME Media School, and DME Media School is part of Delhi Metropolitan Education. DME has three schools. Besides DME Media School, the other two schools are DME Law School and DME Management School. DME is one of the top institutions affiliated to Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University. We have been working on all-round grooming of students, be it curricular, co-curricular or extracurricular activities. And since the time this COVID-19 struck in the month of March, we have done everything possible to further upgrade our technological infrastructure and to rise up to the occasion. We conducted online classes in the last semester only so that the syllabus of the students could be completed. During the summers, we conducted online internships since it was not possible for the students to go to media houses for doing their mandatory internship. Thereafter, when this semester started on 4th of August, so we started the session much ahead as compared to other institutions. And then we adopted the two-fold strategy wherein the teachers produced the video lectures, which were uploaded on Colpol, the ERP system. And then we are conducting the classes wherein the students' queries and doubts are being addressed. So let us have a look on the digital campus of DME.
DME has embraced digital paradigm shift by adopting technology-based learning.
Unlike other colleges, we adopted a two-step strategy. In step one, teachers would be preparing the videos, students would be watching them. In step two, the student would be coming to the tutorial, clarifying the doubts, making the presentations, and discuss with the teacher.
At DME, we have invested in the best in the class academic ERP, which allows us to have a 360-degree robust communication amongst all the stakeholders, students and faculty members.
DME's virtual learning mechanism is no less than real-time classroom teaching,
wherein the students are provided the pool of e-learning resources in the form of PPTs, video lectures and online classes in a very student-friendly environment.
There is no need of mental blocks. Online teaching is as effective and interesting as offline teaching. Let the students enjoy this new mode of education.
In DME, we believe in quality education. We take care of our students. We want to see them happy.
Mental and emotional health are one of the most challenging issues of present times. DME Mentoring Cell takes care of that. Not just this, we go beyond academic curriculum to instill the most important employability skills in our students.
Welcome back to Face to Face. As I was telling you about the program, that this is an initiative of DME Media School. DME Media School is one of the top media institutions in the entire world. We do the things differently. We organize such kind of academic events and other activities which help in the learning and the grooming of the students. And if I can tell you some major things that we do in DME Media School, every year we organize the International Media Conference, that is ICANN. The third edition of ICANN we organized in the month of June only. Earlier it was slated in the month of March, but due to this COVID-19, it could not happen. So we had to have it as a complete online conference, and it turned out to be the world's first digital live conference, which continued for 10 days. Besides this, we organize every year the International Film Festival, SIFI. The second edition of this festival is going to be held in the month of December this year only, and it is going to be a hybrid international film festival. Besides that, we also organize a Media Fest every year, and every month we organize BG Varghese lecture series. This is a special lecture series which has been been instituted in the name of B.G. Varghese, the renowned journalist of contemporary India. Now, talking about face-to-face, this is an interactive program. This is a chat show wherein the dean is talking to three students. These three students are drawn from three different years. At the moment, we have one outgoing batch. This is the batch which should have passed till this time, but then due to COVID-19 and the policy issues, the examination have not taken place. And only today this notification has been made by the university that the exams are going to take place in the last week of this month only. So we treat this batch as the outgoing batch. And then there is one batch which is in third year, the students who have been promoted from fourth semester to fifth semester. And then similarly, the students who are there in the second semester, they have been promoted to third semester. The fresh batch is yet to come. So now, before starting the program, let us have a look as to who all three students are there in today's program. So welcome again to Face to Face. The AV was so interesting that I was engrossed in watching this, and all the three students have multiple talents. So let us uncover all those talents. So at the outset, let us start the conversation with the senior most person here. So Yukta Sharma, she is from the outgoing batch, and also I must name the other students. The third year, this Mohsin Alkab is with us, and from the second year, Yashika Agrawal is with us. So to initiate the discussion with Yukta, Yukta, we have seen in your AV all your interests and passions and all, but we would like to listen from you. How will you express your interest? Yukta?
I am a very creative person, basically. Like, I don't see the boundaries and the things that I have to limit my thinking from, not only to BGMC, but from different fields only. Like, initially I wanted to do designing. I was not into journalism, but then I could not take the admission in my dream college. Then I started with a thing. Then I thought that I should look forward to different creative fields also, not only just to designing in a specific way. So yeah, right now also I do practice all kind of things on fashion and shoe designing and jewelry designing. And then I created my own social media handles to portray myself, to make a platform for myself. Then I got Delhi Metropolitan, and I'm very blessed to have in this college. Like, I get so many faculty members, so many friends who are like as talented as others. And they just inspired me. I really like to inspire others this is the thing I want to tell you.
Yeah. So we found that you are interested in mobile. What kind of achievements you have in this particular field? Can you further elaborate on this?
Like as I started with like all the subjects we are having, like from marketing to analysis and the researching and then creating the things in the media and the production directing. So I thought, why not to give try in every other field? Like I wanted to practice every other field practically, like not only on the theory basis. So I decided I'll be exploring it practically. So I joined the production houses. I even started acting. Even I joined Thabi Theatre also, but then I could not continue it. And then uske baad mein, I started influencing others as I like inspiring people. Like, what are my experiences? What I learn? It doesn't matter if they don't, matlab, if they are not into the things, still they should know that how things work out practically. So I always inspire, matlab, like even my juniors also, I do tell them, go outside, see how the things work. Okay. And like talking about the achievements, I have done so many YouTube channel. I have worked with so many YouTubers also in different, like in a entertainment basis also, in a serious thing also. And I got an opportunity to work with the AFT students also. You know, the AFT, and there is a Marva Studios, right? So they were about to make a kind of a thriller movie. So I initiated to them. I acted with them, had a great experience, how things work out, how direction goes, productions. So yeah, had a great experience.
Okay, so I am curious to know why people should get inspired by you. What is that thing in you?
Okay, because I really believe people should see and people should learn from others. That is what I do. I see other people, then I learn from their experiences also. Doesn't matter if I experience or not, but at least I should know that other people are also experiencing something.
Yeah, but then so you said
basically
you
that is my...
Yeah, but then you said that you want to influence others. So why do you want to influence others? Why do you want to influence others?
Because everybody has some or the other idol in their lives. It can be their friend, it can be their faculty, it can be their parents. And so I also want they should get something to learn from me. I should also have something in myself that people get inspired. So, it makes me confident.
Yeah. So besides modeling, acting, what else you do?
Modeling, acting, the most like my hobby is like to learn daily. I daily edit the things. Like I'm totally into editing. Like I use all the Adobe and all the kind of softwares that are included. So I really like editing. I take up the projects from my friends who are working professionally. I work on those projects and I learn on daily basis. So that is something I love doing.
So moving on to Mohsin. Mohsin, we have seen in your AV that you have so many interests and you are a versatile person as we can look at your profile. But then how will you tell us all about your passion and interest?
Thank you, sir, for giving me the opportunity to speak. Sir, basically the main motto or the short-term or you can say the long-term goal is to see people happy and to be satisfied with themselves. That's the thing I chase for. And that's the thing I thrive for. Because whenever people are sad or whenever people are confused about their lives or maybe their career, anything, then they are stuck. They don't know which road to take. They don't know how to move on. So talking about my interest, sir, I'm a musician, as you had seen in my AV. And I'm a public speaker also. I engage in public speaking a lot and I like to move on through my journeys through public speaking. So I had enrolled myself in a forum. It is an international forum known as the Toastmasters International. It's a club for public speaking and personality development. Rest assured, I also have a website of my own. So it's a website for bloggers, basically. So I also give my contribution to that, and I take contribution from people so that they can express at least what they have in their minds and get to know other people who have similar interests.
What all you do in music?
So music, sir, from a very earlier age, my mom was very keen in making me learn the tabla, as it is considered the maestro of each and every classic instrument. So I have a Visharad degree in tabla. And based on that, sir, when I grew up, when I got the maturity and, you know, the exposure which I was about to get, so I went into music such as rock, metal, and then country music. So I was in a band before. I had a band of my own. I was the drummer there. But now, sir, due to the lockdown situations, I'm jobless.
Okay. You also sing?
Sir, a little bit.
Not, what all you sing?
Sir, Hindi rock and classic rock.
Okay. So what we can listen from you today?
Sir, I have a very sore throat today. I don't think I'd be able to make justice.
No, I mean, it's a chat show. So whatever you sing, we will accept that. And we will, I mean, be confident that you can definitely sing better.
Sir, maybe a time later, sir. I guess because...
Later in this program? No.
No. In the future course of time, whenever we meet in the college or whenever I get the chance to be in the stage or auditorium.
Yeah. But a performer is never hesitant in performing.
Sir, music, sir, I basically play the drums. I'm an instrumentalist, not a singer. Okay. So if I had the drums, then I would have no hesitation in playing it right now.
Okay. So besides music, you said that public speaking, and then what else?
Sir, I like to blog. I like to write blogs.
What kind of blogs you write?
Sir, technology. Sir, new technology and then the products, the new laptops, be it in gaming, be it in professional use, anything that is tech related.
And something more was there in AV. Can you tell us what is left that you haven't told us?
I do public
speaking. Some hypnotism or what? I mean, perhaps.
Yes. Of course. I'm really sorry. I didn't mention that before. Yeah, sir, I'm a level 1 certified hypnotherapist. So
what is it?
Sir, it's basically, I have learned how to self-hypnosis myself. So I can hypnotize myself and make myself do things that normal people can't do. So it's a very easy step. I can, if I have the time, I can explain it to you. So whenever we sleep, so there are three stages, the alpha state, the beta state, and the gamma state. So in the beta state, sir, we are, you know, in the normal state, just like I'm talking to you right now, this is known as the beta state. And there exists the gamma stage. The gamma stage was achieved by the monks, only the Buddhist monks who meditated for a very long time. And then they, through this meditation, achieved such great heights, such great miracles, which normal people can't even think of. So basically what we have to do is while we sleep or whenever we are awake or whenever we are in a trance state, the trance state is actually the stage where we know we are alive, but we don't know subconsciously that we are alive. So it's a very hypothetical term. And then what we need to do is that we need to close our eyes, sit or sleep wherever we are, and retrospect our past the way we want to, not how others want to. So we have to retrospect our past as we want to. Then what happens? We go in certain stages. We go in certain, stages would be good. So we go in certain stages and then we get to know what we did in the past or what we are going to do. So enforcing these thoughts in our mind makes us confused. Our brain gets confused. So whenever the brain gets confused, that's the first stage of hypnosis. So
how do you practice it?
So while sleeping, sir. Actually, personally speaking or subjectively speaking, while I go to sleep at night, I dream of what I want to be. Of not what others tell me to be, of what I want to be.
Okay.
Basically, sir, it's a very simple statement, but if I go deep into this, then I guess the session won't end today. So,
and whether you use it on others also?
Sir, on others, sir, actually, I have to master it on my own before implementing it on others. So I'm trying to master this skill.
Yeah. Okay. And, so good. I mean, it was really interesting to know all about this. Now, moving on to Yashika, I put the same question to you. I mean, what can you tell us about your passion and interest?
Sir, basically, I like to read and write. So I read about, read books and some authors which I like. And I do not prefer some particular genre, but I read content because I like to get, I like to write content, so I read. And writing is something I have always been connected to. I started writing when I was, I guess, in class 7th, 8th. And I also like to be on stage, and that is why when I came here, I joined Tabir. Tabir has literally contributed in my personal growth, like from day one. Through the entire year, if I see, Tabir has given me like the confidence to be on stage, the personality grooming and everything altogether. So yeah, I like to read, write, and acting. And all.
Okay, so what all plays you have done in Tabir?
Yeah, sir. Initially, when we came here, we did a Nukkad Natak named Aparadh. Then after that, there was Anugunj. So for prelims, we did Aina. One act.
Okay. So you were interested in theater in school also, or you started this in college only?
Sir, in school, it was basically skit based or like the plays we used to have on stage. I was always a person who used to be there on stage because I loved it. And yes, but I took it like professionally. I learned from my seniors, from teachers, mentors, after coming here only, after coming to class.
Okay. So what else you do besides acting in theater?
Sir, I'm in a newsletter for the because I like to write, so I joined the newsletter also. It has also given me like the confidence and a flair in writing, basically. So currently, I'm in from the college side. I'm involved in newsletter and theater only. And in free time, I really like to write for myself and not for anything else.
Can you tell us something more about your contribution or about your involvement in the newsletter activity?
Yeah, yeah. So in newsletter, I have covered various events. I covered Ritika. Then I have covered Icon recently, some events which as we were assigned then. BG Vagi series is something which gives us time to literally listen to people who have so much experience. So for newsletter only, I literally attended those sessions, wrote about the people. They were very influential. I've learned a lot. Then in newsletter, we have wrote about like various online sessions which we were having. So that all I have covered recently.
And since when you have been part of the newsletter? I mean, since you joined the college?
Since I joined. So both things starting. So.
Okay. So besides this, what else? I mean, what do you read?
Sir, I am some author-based person. I like to read Paulo Coelho, Khaled Hosseini, and I'm a Potterhead, so obviously J.K. Rowling. I love to read Harry Potter. So yeah, I'm this person. If there is some book on like Paulo Coelho or Khaled Hosseini is like my personal favorite, so I just read the book because of the author.
Okay. Anything else where your interest is?
Sir, I like to paint. Thoda bahut.
Kya paint karti ho?
Sir, when I was in college, when I was in school, so I participated in some competitions, state level competitions. Actually, I'm from Uttarakhand, so I represented Uttarakhand at places. If you must remember, there was this Run for Unity. I was in 11th standard back then. So from Uttarakhand's team, I participated in painting there. It was like a diversity base. So yeah, I like to paint random things. I paint. I don't have a genre in that.
Okay, which place you belong to?
Sir, Haridwar.
So you have come here only for studies?
Yes, sir. I live by my own.
Okay, so moving on to Yukta again. Yukta, you have been there for 3 years, rather more than 3 years in DME. So during this period, you would have made a number of friends, and different teachers would have been teaching you different subjects in different semesters, and then you must be enjoying the college life. So what all you can tell us about your friends, your bonding with teachers, and the college life?
So the first thing I would like to tell that I miss college. I miss everybody. Even I'm like some days earlier, farewell happened on like online thing only. So I became so emotional. I was like, I just want to happen this in college and not online. And I wanted to talk, and I wanted to talk to all the faculty members, to all the friends. I actually miss all the things, especially the Aloha. Like, I participated in that also, and usse pehle Vritika also. And so, like, I miss my participation in everything. Like, I want everybody to be surrounded to. Even Bala ma'am, when she always scolds that you should attend the class, right now I'm missing that also. I want her to scold right now.
So you're missing the scolding?
Yeah, even I'm missing that also. I want somebody to scold me or so say, tell me to sit in the class or do this or do that. But I'm not getting anything.
Yeah, but then why were you not attending the classes regularly?
We were just roaming here and there sometimes, attending classes in between. Then Pramod sir used to come and he used to say, ki, what are you doing? You should attend and you should give this project and that project. And yeah.
I mean, I understand. In this age, it becomes difficult to remain stationary. I mean, every young person wants to explore this, explore that. That's the reason behind, I believe. Isn't it?
Yeah, but now I just miss that thing also that I got scolded.
Yeah, but then as far as your this farewell is concerned, as soon as things normalize, we have already planned, and Bala ma'am even announced this, we will have the offline, the face-to-face mode of farewell for you people.
I'm just waiting.
Yeah, I mean, teachers are also waiting to meet you all.
Yeah.
Okay, so moving on to Mohsin, what will you tell us about your friends, teachers, and the college?
Sir, before coming to DME, I was a lone wolf. I didn't have many friends. I didn't connect with people, and I was an introvert. In a nutshell, mm-hmm. I was an introvert. Mm-hmm. But sir, after joining DME, after getting to know the people here, the teachers, the professors, the faculty members, I'm sorry, the teachers are the same. I mean, everyone from the security guard till the professor, everyone was very friendly to me, and from everyone, I had to learn something and got the opportunity to see something new. So that's one of the most important things I want to elicit today. And sir, talking of the academics, sir, one of the best, I mean, each and every professor helps us whenever we are in need, whenever we are in trouble. And they clarify all our doubts. And talking of friends, sir, whenever it was the first day of my college, I still remember, it was deserted. There was no one in my class. So I was among only the 4 or 5 students who were coming for the first day of the college. But sir, I wasn't expecting that these 5 people would come to me and speak to me or, you know, get to know me. And that was one of the things I liked. You know, the exposure and the open-mindedness of people in the college. So that was one of the things I would like to appreciate. And sir, one more thing is that the assignments were really, I'm missing those now, because that at that time, whenever we were given a deadline to submit any assignment, then I used to be very serious in submitting those assignments because I needed the marks. And speaking of which, I was in VIT, Vellore Institute of Technology. It's an engineering college. So I was for 1 year there. I was doing engineering. So I thought that, no, I won't be able to survive engineering. So I told my dad that I don't want to do engineering. Just take me out of this college. He was like, wow, then why did you even give the entrance exam? And you cleared the entrance exam. Then I said that, no, that I have some other options and I have some other things to do. So, and then DME showed me the way. DME made my way clearer to my goals, to my aspirations.
Which place you belong to?
Sir, Assam. It's a northeast, Assam.
Yeah, everybody knows about Assam. So from Assam, how did you land in Delhi?
Sir, at Delhi, actually, I wanted the exposure. I wanted the exposure, actually, the way how Delhiites work, the way how Delhiites act, the way how Delhiites interact with things. I wanted to learn from them. I wanted to know how they manage things. So that was the one reason I came to Delhi. And the second reason was that Delhi is the capital of India, sir. So, you know, I'm a country boy, sir. I'm a country boy, and then I like to go to cities and explore the things and know the people, know new stuff. So Delhi provided me that.
Okay, so since the time, I mean, almost 2 years you have been in Delhi. Do you live in Delhi or Noida?
Sir, Delhi. I go to Delhi recently, but my permanent residence, so that I can go to college every day, is in Noida, sir. So I'm staying at Noida.
So for the last 2 years, what all you have explored about the city and the people?
Sir, should I talk about Delhi or?
Noida? I mean, put it as like Delhi and NCR. So both the places are covered there.
Yes, sir. I would really love to express that.
Yeah.
Sir, it's just a subjective point of view. No offense to anyone.
Yeah.
Everyone is open-minded. Everyone is helpful. But there are some certain perceptions and perspectives of people which they refrain to act for. That's the most common thing I've seen in Noida and Delhi. But sir, we at Assam order people from hills, basically. We are very simple people, sir. We have a very simple mindset. We like to do simple things. We like to interact simply. So we are very straightforward. But sir, Delhiites or Noida people, sir, again, I'm saying no offense. Sir, they are very critical and they think differently. So
particularly about Northeast, you want to indicate that, isn't it? No.
Actually, Northeast is also filled with very bad things. I won't be saying it out loud now, but you can say that, sir.
Okay, so moving on to Yashika. Yashika, what will you tell us about your friends, teachers, and the college?
Sir, even I'm an outsider. So initially, when I got here, so I was very scared, obviously. Ek mahina to aise bas blend in hone mein lag jata hai.
नहीं वैसे वैसे याशिका मैं बताऊं जैसे मोहसिन भी कह रहे थे इफ यू लुक इनटू द फिगर्स इन द एंटायर वर्ल्ड एंड आल्सो इफ यू गो इनटू द नंबर्स इवन विद इन द कंट्री विद इन इंडिया मोस्ट ऑफ अस आर द माइग्रेंट्स सो नोबडी शुड फील दैट वी आर द आउटसाइडर्स एवरी अदर पर्सन इज एन आउटसाइडर
Yeah,
and sir. the only thing that we need to learn that we need to learn to live in harmony. That's the thing.
Yes, sir. We are a land of diversity, and this is all what we have. You're absolutely correct. So this is what happened. Actually, I didn't have my parents here, so I was just blending it. It was my first day of college. Not actually college. I was with my parents only. We were visiting, and Bala ma'am introduced me to Shreya. She was my first friend, Shreya Singh. She has been here, you must have heard of her, and she's my roommate. So she has been my initial friend since then throughout the year. I have two other friends, Shivansh and Rahul. So basically we are three people, we do projects together, we sit together, we are the people, we have a small group, we are happy in it. And then my other friends group is obviously Taveer. They have been very supportive because obviously we spend so much time in practice sessions that we have literally come close. So Shubham is there, Siddharth Bhaiya, Varsha Didi, and then not just that, Shreya is there, Shreya Jha, and then a lot of people. So it's like a family, very comforting environment. And teachers, Mohit sir. I literally call Mohit sir for everything. Even if he's not the concerned teacher, I call him and tell my problems. Sir, please help me. And from day one, he has been very helpful to me. I'm literally guilty in this thing that I do this to sir. But yes, even other teachers like Kamil sir, Deepika ma'am, they have been very nice. But with Mohit sir, I feel a lot of comfort.
अरे तुमने अभी सारे टीचर्स का नाम तो लिया नहीं, फिर बाकी टीचर्स कहेंगे तुमने उनका नाम नहीं लिया।
सर मैं इंटरेक्ट कम कर पाती हूँ टीचर्स से, मतलब दिस इज़ तो मैं मोहित सर से इंटरेक्ट कर लेती हूँ।
As far as I remember कि तुम्हारे पेरेंट्स आए थे पहली बार तो मुझसे मिले थे एंड दे वांटेड यू नॉट टू टेक एडमिशन इन दिल्ली और नोएडा।
Yes, so they were scared. Actually, they were scared for BGMC only. So my dad was not very sure, even the day he filled in the fees, the day I started going to college, and after 1 year also, he's very comfortable with it. But that is the, I guess, reason. Otherwise, they were very happy from DME.
So again, moving on to Yukta, we want to know about your family, your parents, and the kind of support, if you are getting that support from your family.
My family has always been supportive, but like right now, I live in Delhi only. Right now, I'm in Rajasthan at my nani's place, and I have a very big joint family here. So this is India now.
I mean, incidentally, you all three have some connections from outside Delhi.
No, I live in Delhi.
मोहसिन के जो वो कुछ reservations थे, I'm addressing that, कि सारे ही लोग बाहर के। हाँ ठीक है, तो आगे युक्ता।
No sir, I'm from Delhi only. Right now I'm in
Rajasthan. नानी है ना वहाँ पे राजस्थान में। हाँ तो कहाँ पे है राजस्थान में?
साला सर।
So you are telling us something. Yeah. Continue.
Yeah, so I have a joint family like. My dad, my mom, siblings, then my grandmother, then my chachu, chachi and their kid. And here also I have a big joint family, like all the mamas, mamis, nana, nani and everybody, all the cousins. They always support me in everything, but they always have that thing that ki, are you correct on this point or not? Will you be able to do the things or not? Are you confident? So, and mass communication also, still they have a big question mark in their head that, is it gonna make a good effect in my life? Because according to them, it is like, basically the studies are like BBA and BBA and the law and these kind of things only. Like they ask me that you never study, you don't have any books, you never take out the books and you just calculate the things and study and all. So still they are like, you are, today also I told them ki I'm gonna have exams at the end of the September. They were like, and where are your books? Like, I don't have my books. There are no books.
But why don't you read?
Because I read from my phone. I have all the PDFs and all the books downloaded in my phone. So they keep on asking me, you never study. And they think that I am not a study kind of a person. But yeah, I do. I do study from my phone.
Nowadays, I mean, you can make them understand that we have this multimedia device wherein everything is in our phone and laptop. So obviously the hard books days are almost gone, if not completely.
Yeah. I told them, now they are like okay with it. But initially when I was in first year, they were totally like, oh God, exams are coming and where are your books? I told them, it's not my 11th and 12th standard. Come on, I have all the PDFs in my phone. I'll study. I won't let you down. Don't worry.
And then again, college life is not about studies always.
Yeah, but still they are. There should be. Because it is only me in the whole family who is into this kind of a field. All others are like, pursuing IPS and doing this exam and pursuing law, and then they see them also studying, so they are like, you should also have some or the other thing, no? And I was like, oh.
But creative people have a different life altogether, different approach to life. So yeah. That's true. I mean, since you are a creative person, so you have to go that way. Now, Mohsin, if I ask you about your family, though you referred something already about your mother, you told us, then what about your father and your siblings and all?
Yeah. So, without my parents, I would be nothing now. That's the main thing. One of the biggest things which I want to elicit now. And right after I left my engineering college, my father was the only person because of whom I'm still alive. Because, sir, after coming out from such a prestigious college like VIT, there are a lot of critics and cynics, sir. They are full of critics, sir. They always criticize me saying that, why did you take engineering then? Why did you even give the exams if you had to come out of the engineering college? And some people are like, you got the computer science branch, brother, and you left engineering. And I was like, I didn't find interest. That's why I left. I'm just straightforward, sir. And because of that, I thank my parents. And one more thing I missed before, I would like to say it now, that Sir Dr. Atul Arora, so it was because of him I have learned many things, sir. From knowing how to read a newspaper to writing an article, it was Dr. Atul Arora, sir, who has helped me a lot throughout the college. And sir, talking of my siblings, I have a little sister. She is at class 5. And my father is an engineer himself. So, he was really annoyed when I left engineering. Then he was like, he was very stressed out. But it was because of him I'm now at TME. And my mother, she is a working person. She works at NRL, Numaligarh Refinery Limited. It's a oil refinery, basically like Engineers India Limited or oil or GAIL. Any oil firm, you can say. So both of my parents are working and...
So your mother is also an engineer?
No. She's not an engineer. She's a commerce graduate. And she works... I don't know. I never asked my mother what she does, because anything she does, she is keeping me happy. And that's the most important thing for me. So, yeah.
Okay, so moving on to Yashika, what will you tell us about your parents? I think the greatest thing that they have done, that they have allowed you to stay in Noida and studying in DME, isn't it?
Yes, sir. So my dad and my mom, they have always been supportive when it was to come out of home. I have an elder sister. Even she moved out for college because as in Haridwar, we do not have that much opportunities for, and that too for BGMC, to koi college nahi hai. Hai hi nahi college. So there was no, they were expecting that I'll do BB or BCom because I'm from a commerce background. Though I was preparing them from very early stage, like I was very clear from my 8th standard that I have to do BGMC. I was preparing them still, it came as a shock. So they tried to understand what the profession is, and then they tried to be supportive. I won't say they were like right away supportive. So yes, and I'm very close to my mom. She is someone whom I tell every stop to, whether I'm in a PG. She calls me the entire day, like 5 times, 6 times a day, that did you eat, did you do this? So we are very close. And as I'm an outsider, so I didn't have my parents there. So I used to visit to my chachu's place and bua's place. They are like my second parents. Because 1 year se unhone mera khyal rakha hai, mere parents to the nahi. So I'm very close to them. So this is all about my family.
Okay, great. So moving on to Yukta again, any final thing that you want to tell us, because you will have your exams in September, then you will move out of DME, what all you will do, what you all, you aspire to do, anything that you want to tell us?
First of all, I'm very sad that I'm leaving DME. I'm very sad. Actually, seriously, I don't want to leave. I'm ready to study once again.
study to obviously, if you have bachelor's degree in hand, there's no point in staying for study. But then you are always welcome. If you have studied in this college, you are always welcome. Your juniors are there. Your teachers are there. When the things normalize, you are welcome. And you can maintain that communication by coming and even by not coming, the kind of technology that we have these days. Even then, that is possible. Yeah.
Yeah. And for the future, I'm just waiting right now to just get things normalized. And then I want to do job right now. I want to get into the field. I want to see, I want to explore a bit more to just see the things. Like, still I am confused that on which direction should I go. I'm confident enough to just pursue anything. But and I know I'll be doing it, but still I'm a bit confused that which direction to go. So I have decided I'll be doing job in a creative field only. So I'll be pursuing in some good companies, talking to some PRs or the managers or something. So like right now also I have started pursuing. I'm getting some offer letters also, but I'm comparing the things. How my abilities will gonna work, is it worthy or not? And so I'll start with those things in few months.
So thank you, Yukta. Now moving on to Mohsin. Mohsin, any final word that you want to say?
Sir, I don't have any final words to say because...
It's still 1 year to go, so you will wait for that final word.
Sir, but still, I would like to say just one thing, sir, that it just takes a single step or a small step for achieving something big. So I would like to persuade people to do so because our generation is really a very procrastinating generation. We don't like to read. We don't like to engage in some things which are, we don't like to do things which we don't like. So doing things we don't like will make us achieve heights. Will make us do miracles. And sir, one more thing I want to address today. There were two seniors. One was Adarsh Sharma and one was Jyoti Bhushan. So Jyoti Bhushan, rest in peace, sir. He was one of my very good brothers. There was a very tragic incident with him. I don't want to bring it back, sir. But sir, Adarsh Sharma, he's one of my seniors and he helped me a lot, sir, throughout the journey. He made me learn new things. He made me how to read. He gave me an exposure basically to everything.
He is really good. He was also in one of the episodes of Face to Face. And I have also found among all the students in DME, he is one person who read the most. And
yes, he does.
And he's really, a knowledgeable person. And that thirst for knowledge is always there. So,
sir, and one more senior, sir, Saket Tejaswi.
Yeah,
it's his friend. So yeah, these two people helped me a lot, sir, a lot. I can't just elicit today.
Yeah, so here I would like to add one thing since you said something. So taking a string from there only. Both you and both these persons, they belong to the eastern part of the country and which is more inclined towards knowledge as compared to, there's no comparison that way. But that is something which is more prevalent in the eastern side. People are more oriented towards study, towards knowing more things in life. So that is one thing. Okay, so... So moving on to Yashika, any final thing in one sentence?
Just that people who are in BGMC or who are thinking of doing BGMC, I guess this is a field which gives you time to explore yourself. And I guess everyone should do it if they want to.
Thank you, Yashika. Thank you all. But before concluding, I would like to make a mention of my team. this program would not have been possible without the support of all the faculty members of DME Media School. Particularly, I want to make a mention of the creative and the production team, which comprises Deepika Dhawan, Sumantra Sarthi Das, and Ritik Ghosh, and above all, Dr. Susmita Bala and the entire DME Media School team. I thank you all. I thank you people also for making this whole episode so lively and interesting. Thank you all.